Hey Kyle, what are you drinking?
It's my cola.
Oh yeah?
Yeah? Wait, hey.
Now it's my cola.
Right. That was a totally random clip of a totally random encounter I had with a complete stranger, spur of the moment video that I made when I realized that the brand of the soda was my cola, and it could be turned into a really smart play on words because it's actually everyone's cola as long as you're holding it. What's up, everyone? My name is Son of Terra 92, and you're watching right now a clip from my GoPro head cam of me picking up my brother at the airport. He recently came back from France and he's now living at home. Everything's well on this end. I want to make a really quick video talking about some stuff, sort of like a random wisdom from the frontier sort of video. No, I had a better title for this. It's called Wisdom from a Wandering Scientist or something like that. Wisdom from a Wandering Scientist. I just want to take some time to talk about some of the wisdom that I have gained in my 22 years of existence on this pale blue dot. I want to make a really quick podcast-like journey video to talk about one of the important elements of being a human being. And I'd like to start this vlog off with a story. I actually have a friend, let's just call him Yaz, and he's been my friend for the past 4 years and we've been really close, but sometimes we have our falling outs, but then we always come back to share and talk experiences, dreams, and aspirations with each other. And this guy, Yaz, he's pretty much similar to me in a lot of respects. For all of you who don't know, I'm actually still in college right now. As this video is being made, I'm in my final year of engineering, so I only have 1 year left. And the thing is, I didn't have to pay a single cent for college other than some cost on the side. Well, my parents didn't have to pay anything. I'm a student on a full scholarship by the Telecom Foundation, and they basically pay for our tuition and they give us a bit of extra pocket money for us to do what we wish. Now, my friend Yaz, not his real name, but my friend is actually on the same scholarship, and one of the biggest things about this scholarship is that we have to pay back the entirety of the 4 years, actually 5 years if you include foundation year, by working for this telecom company, which is a national company here in Malaysia. It's pretty big. It's got business affairs all across the country, and it's even making it internationally from what I learned from my internship. This company called Telecom Malaysia has promised us actually a lot of good money if we work for them. But something that I've had to struggle with for the past 5 years, and that is, I actually don't want to work for Telecom Malaysia. I don't want to become another cog in the corporate machine, and that's part of the reason why I make these videos, to preserve that part of who I am that I consider very important and that I consider true to my individuality. It's important for all human beings to get an opportunity to express themselves. The mind is a beautiful place to begin reality. The mind is capable of molding reality into awesome, awesome things like how Jason Silva would put it, iPads and space shuttles, right? Both me and my friend Yaz actually share the same opinion that once you work for telecom, it's kind of a 9-to-5 corporate life where you just obey, and at the end of every month they feed you money so you can get by. The main differences that I share between me and my friend is that I'm willing to take a chance and risk everything to torch that deal that I had with Telecom Malaysia. I'm just gonna say it out loud right now that I'm gonna burn that contract. It's going to lead me down a road of confrontation in the future, but I think there's no other way that I desire to live my life other than to risk it all once I graduate. So this is where me and my friend have like the biggest differences. He would say, oh, you're just saying that you're gonna take a chance after this, and what if you fail, and why are you risking so much? And I think it's because it's who I am. If you've ever watched a really good movie, you'll notice that the strong characters are the ones that are willing to stand for the craziest of ideals. That's what makes an interesting character, and that's what makes a fictional character come to life, when that person has something that is ridiculous but he's willing to stand for it, and you kind of feel for that person because that is the struggle of life. Look at Naruto. he's just this one shrimpy kid from the ass end of nowhere who wants to become the greatest thing ever. I would say that the struggle is reflected in a lot of people based on the choices they make. I'm from a small town called Bandarbarubangi, and all I want to do now is just get the hell out of that town. Of course, that is kind of like an anthem for a lot of pop punk music, for you to just leave the town that you were from. And it's almost become a trope, but it is true. I want to escape from this place and just liberate myself so much. Now, I've been going to college for the past 4 years, and I definitely have my own plans with what I want to do with my life afterwards. And I would say that a lot of these plans bring me into confrontation with my parents, with my friend Yaz, with Telecom Malaysia, obviously, and with society in general. I want to try to become a science communicator after this and just live that life of wanderer throughout planet Earth and maybe even the solar system if we get the chance. I remember one notable argument he made while we were in line at Burger King, and I said, "Dude, like, I'm not gonna stay here beyond next year once I graduate." And he said, "You're just saying that now, but once you graduate, you're just gonna end up kissing ass with Telecom just like the rest of us." And I told him, "Fuck it. I've had enough with the road of the safe and the sheltered existence in the past 4 years. And I want to go out after this and just put my life on the line, because one of the moments of being a human being and when you truly feel alive is when you are able to stand for something that you believe in. The fact that you've stood for that and walked that unknown road towards that objective, that's what makes you feel alive. Don't go for the safe and ordinary. I'm tired of the safe and ordinary. I've had the safe and ordinary for the past 5 years and it hasn't made my life any better. Deep down inside, I haven't found any solace or comfort from it. I am not proud that I've had to put up with, like, what, hundreds of hours of coursework and hundreds of exams and tests and midterms. And even though I did fairly well at them, I am not proud of any of those achievements, because to walk down that path in life wasn't my own decision. So I don't really derive any passion and strength and power from it. So I've decided that after college, I'm just gonna go out there and find it. I wanna go out there, and even if I have to, like, sleep on the fucking street, even if I have to end up living at a quarter of the state of living I could live if I chose to take up a 9-to-5 corporate job earning money doing engineering, fuck it. I don't really care whether I end up poor, broke, on the side of the street. The fact that I wagered my existence for this one objective, that has made my life all the more richer. And I think that's part of the rush of being a human being, that you're given opportunities in life and love, and based on what you do with it, profoundly affects the outcome of your existence and those around you. It's up to you how to realize that. But the sad fact of the matter is that a large majority of human beings prefer to choose a life of the ordinary and resignment, compared to tapping into their own potential of awesome and taking a chance, a leap of faith and audacity to realize that dream, all because they preferred safe and sound over new and scary. And my experience with my friend Yaz and the entirety of the past 4 years has taught me that. Here's what it's been like for the past 4 years. I've been sponsored by Telecom Malaysia and I've gotten a lot of good money for it. I've always been secure in terms of my financial resources. And what I had to trade for that was my free will. Going back to my friend, we're both from upper middle class families and we're both on the same scholarship, but I want to go out there and take a chance on doing something that I believe will enrich humanity, communicating science through on a higher level, because that's my passion. And somehow through following my passion, I can find a way to make money off of it and do well with it and live a more satisfying life, as well as benefiting fellow human beings. While Yaz, on the other hand, he's probably much more comfortable with continuing to live a more sheltered existence, earning a crap ton of money, while at the end of the day you're swallowing this 9-to-5 that you yourself realize that, hey, this is not how we should be living. 99.9% of the human race has probably had to make decisions like this because they weighed it based on the immediate benefits, on the benefits of, oh, I'm going to get lots of cash, I'm going to be financially secure, I am going to be safe. I realize that I'm an individual that just can't live like that, not anymore, after going through what I've experienced in the past 4 years and the trade-off and the comparison between living safe and sacrificing your desires compared to pursuing your desires and putting yourself out there to be outside of your comfort zone and chasing for what you want. I think it's best summarized in the Sith code. To all you geeks out there, if you watch Star Wars, the Sith are the bad guys from Star Wars. For the most part, they look like the bad guys, but once you kind of start to understand their philosophy, and you kind of realize that, hey, maybe they're onto something. Now, the Sith code is something that all Sith live by, and it goes, peace is a lie, there is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, I gain power. Through power, I gain victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. The Force shall free me. The Sith code is interesting because it talks about such strong words like passion, strength, and power. It basically tells the person to just liberate themselves, which is different compared to the Jedi code, which is more about restraint. What makes human existence special is our ability to pursue passion, whether that be in our dreams and desires or in other human beings or whatever you want. Of course, as long as you don't hurt anybody, that's my philosophy, because if you hurt anybody else, you would likewise end up in a pretty bad spot yourself. What makes higher intelligence remarkable is this ability that we all have to make our own meaning in life. And one of those things that I've had to break free from in the past 4 years was the meaning of other people and finding and creating my own meaning. I think if you go to college, even if you don't really truly understand what it is that old guy is telling you up in front, I think the best thing that you could get out of going to college is this. I'd like to echo the words of one of my heroes, Richard Feynman, who said that he was not afraid of not knowing about the unknown parts, the missing parts of human understanding in the universe. Of course, he was using it in a completely different context. What I want to add on top of that is that I'm not afraid of not knowing where the road of the new and scary will lead me to after I graduate. All I know is that I have to walk this road because it'll make me a better person. It'll make me a human being that is more in touch with reality. Compared to that same person living the safe and sound, working a 9-to-5 job plugged into the matrix for Telkom Malaysia. In conclusion, I'd like to say that the measure of the richness of the life of a human being is in how much they are actually able to liberate themselves and see through the cloudy haze and mist of existence and live like how, was it Liverpool's captain the other day? I don't know who, it was Wayne Rooney. During that match with this other team, I'm not too big of a football fan, but he said it on an interview that the moment he was playing that match, every minute felt like an hour because it was such a rush. Of course, that's the kind of feeling you want to get when you live life on the edge all the time, following your passion. That's what I want to say. And in comparison, with all due respect to my friend, I won't get a rush out of working 9-to-5 at Telekom Malaysia doing engineering, something that I've been hating for the past 4 years, and I'm gonna do it even more. Don't you think that's kind of retarded? I think that's very retarded. So yeah, I want to go out there and find my own head rush of where an existence in which every minute doing what I do, the things that I'm good at and things that I love to do, every minute of doing it would feel like an hour of existence, and you just maximize your existence doing it. I've talked long enough about this. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next video. Boop!